the bullet train. Prime Minister Narendra Modi's foreign trips are finally paying off.
I've got a gift for my people.
At 320 km per hour, the bullet train will run between Mumbai and Sabarmati and reduce the travel time from 7 to under 3 hours. Expected to be completed in time for India's 75th independence celebration in 2022, this 508-kilometer route will largely be elevated with only 27 kilometers in undersea tunnels. 12 stops with a ticket price about 20% cheaper than an airplane. But the unfortunate tragedy in Mumbai, where 23 people were killed in a stampede, has created a backlash against the project. Sign the petition to divert 1,10,000 crore being spent on the bullet train to instead be spent on Mumbai's train infrastructure. Their anger is justified. India's and Mumbai's railways are precarious, overcrowded trains, with frequent derailments and mishaps resulting in several deaths every month. But scrapping the bullet train will not lead to better infrastructure in Mumbai or elsewhere, as their budgets are different. Some oppose the project. First build toilets, then build trains. But that's so stupid.
Tomorrow you will tell me don't wear shoes to work because others can only afford sandals. Lol.
Others wrongly believe the 17 billion price tag is too high. Compared to what? In a single year, 2017, state governments waived off farmer loans 3.5 times the cost of the bullet train, $58 billion. While the cost of the train will be spread over 50 years on loans given by Japan, which together with interest will cost India just $450 million a year.
We will give a loan of $13 billion of the $17 billion, which India doesn't need to start repaying until 2037. That too at 0.1% interest.
Today, if you went to your bank for a housing loan, I'll start paying back your loan after 15 years and only pay 0.1% interest.
Get lost. You want me to shut down my bank?
So India would benefit by getting a high-speed rail network for almost one quarter the price and additionally get 20,000 jobs during construction of the project, 4,000 permanent jobs in maintenance and operation of the train, manufacturing jobs for the parts the train will use under Make in India, resulting in the learning of new technologies which entrepreneurs can then use in other areas. Once the route begins, factories and housing along the tracks will sprout, decongesting cities. In Uzbekistan, the Tashkent-Samarkand and Tashkent-Bukhara route has created a huge jump in tourist arrivals, promoting construction of new hotels, car hires, restaurants and jobs. All this additional activity in India will lead to an increase in GDP, allowing it to build the bullet train virtually for free and maybe even at a profit. The Shinkansen technology will also save Indian lives. Never once in over 50 years has a passenger been killed in an accident, not even during the big earthquake of March 2011. It's time India joins the other 16 nations having a high-speed rail network. The Shinkansen was first built in 1964, connecting the cities of Tokyo and Osaka. Europe's first high-speed train was in 1977 between Florence and Rome. China today has over 26,000 kilometers of high-speed rail network, with the maglev touching speeds of over 400 kilometers per hour. India's fastest train, the Rajdhani, runs at 120 kilometers per hour, which in today's world is an embarrassment. In 1966, when car crazy Sanjay Gandhi returned from automobile training in England to make a people's car, he faced opposition from the very same type of people opposing the bullet train today. That car is called Maruti, and India rides in it. Modi believes in bold steps to take India into the 21st century. And this is yet another of his bold moves after demonetization, GST and the conversion to electric cars. Bisbo's Limerick. Let's celebrate the bullet train. India has so much to gain. New jobs for one, new technologies will come. Why do some people only complain?
If you like this video, share it with your friends and become Bisbo's friend by subscribing for free to Bisbo's YouTube channel.